Hey guys, I'm glad to be with you again today. I sure miss seeing your smiling faces and everybody running around on Wednesday, but at least we can be together through our technology. And we're going to do our lesson again today on taste and see, you know, the cereal lessons we've been doing. So who can say our Bible verse with me? I know you remember it. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the person who goes to him for safety. Psalm 34:8. That's the verse we've been saying every Wednesday. And this Wednesday, we are talking about Cocoa Puffs. Have you ever eaten Cocoa Puffs cereal? Well, the thing about Cocoa Puffs is it's kind of a light cereal. It's a light and airy cereal. When you put milk on it, it doesn't weigh down much like that Captain Crunch or even Cocoa Pebbles does. It's not a real heavy cereal. It stays light in the milk and it's kind of airy and puffy. And you can eat a lot of it without that heavy feeling. I kind of like that myself. It's a good breakfast time. No wonder old Looney Bird on here goes, Cocoa for Cocoa Puffs, Cocoa for Cocoa Puffs. You ever see him do that on the commercial? That's what he says. And it has that chocolatey goodness at the end. Makes chocolates good. You know, Cocoa Puffs is even a great snack by itself. Sometimes when I'm having a bad day, that chocolatey snack is really good. Now, it can't solve the problem because after all, it is just a cereal that we have. But it can kind of make you feel better, I guess. But then what happens when all the cereal's gone? Who do we turn to? What do we do to have a better day, even after the cereal's gone? You know, sometimes we get weighed down by things that happen to us. We have problems. And right now, everybody being hemmed up and staying in is causing people a lot of stress. It might be causing you some stress, too, when we just feel kind of weighed down by our problems and we try to juggle our problems, kind of like this ball. No matter what you do, it just keeps coming down on you. You can't just have a hard time with everything that's going on. Maybe trying to get your schoolwork done from home, trying to get along with your brothers and your sisters and your parents, trying to manage everything right now. What happens when we're just too weighed down? You know what? Today, I have good news for you. Like the Cocoa Puffs or the puffy cereal, something to help lighten your burden, I have good news for you. And that is that Jesus Christ, your Creator, your Savior, the one who loves you the most in this world, came to earth so that you could know Him personally, so that He could show you how much He loves you and that He wants you to let Him be in your life and help carry those heavy burdens that we have. Our scripture today comes from Matthew 11:25-30. I hope you have your Bibles with you so you can look that up. Matthew 11:25-30. It reads, At that time Jesus said, I praise you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and intelligent and have shown them to the children. Indeed, Father, this brings you happiness. My Father has handed all things over to me. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wants to reveal Him. Come to me, all you who are struggling hard and carrying heavy loads, and I will give you rest. Put on my yoke and learn from me. I'm gentle and humble, and you will find rest for yourselves. My yoke is easy to bear, and my burden is light. Those are wonderful words that Jesus said to us. I wonder what he meant when he said a yoke. Do you know what he meant when he said a yolk? Not like an egg yolk. What he meant was a yolk was a wooden piece that farmers would put on their oxen when they were going to work in the field. And it was kind of heavy for them, and yet they could go where they needed to go. Well, Jesus was just telling us that when we follow him, the yoke that we wear as his followers is light. It's not a heavy one. He helps us with that yoke. Many times we have problems and we face hardships, whatever it is. Many times, and a lot of times people say, just be tough. Just toughen up. That's what life is like. It's hard. Well, sometimes it is. And we will always have hardships and problems. But there's times when we need to toughen up and face our problems. But there's also times when we feel like we're at the end of our rope and we wonder where we can go. Well, you can always go to Jesus because he loves you so much. And he even said, I give this information to the kids, to the children, to the babies, so they'll know how much I love him. Jesus doesn't want you to go anything alone. He wants you to give your burdens and your problems to him so that he can help lighten the load, make it lighter, make everything easier during the hard times. It's easier because you know if you trust him, he's going to help you through it. Now, he might not take everything away right in a very instant, but he's going to walk with you through everything that you're going through. Just like trying to keep the ball up, guess what? Thank you, Jesus, that like this helium balloon, he helps to lighten our burdens. Now, I know what you're thinking. Why would Jesus care about me? I'm just a kid. And anyway, my problems aren't as important as somebody else's, maybe. But Jesus does love you. He loves you very much, and he wants to help you with any problems. In fact, Jesus loved you so much that he gave his son. God loved you so much that he gave his son, Jesus Christ. And Jesus loved you so much that he was willing to go to the cross to die for you to help lighten those burdens and those problems that you have. You know, we can all take our problems to God and know he's listening to everything we have to tell him. All you have to do is pray. All you have to do is tell him your problems. God knows what problems you have, what burdens you have today. He knew it before you ever stepped foot out of your bed today, what problems you might have. So if you're struggling, getting along during this hard time, go to Jesus, talk to him. Jesus cares. Ask him to take your burdens. Ask him to lighten your load and say, thank you, Jesus, for being there for me. Thank you for lightening the load. Thank you for doing all that you do for us. Jesus cares. Ask Jesus to help you, and he'll lighten your load. Maybe we'll not just say, cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs. Maybe we'll say, cuckoo for Jesus love. Cuckoo for Jesus love. Think about that today. Let's close with a prayer. Thank you for sending Jesus so that we never have to face our troubles and our problems alone. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you guys for being with us. I hope to see you next week. Everybody stay safe. If you get a chance, read your Bible verse. Have a great day. I love everybody and I miss you.